were sold out here in Edinburgh. 99.9% will be cheering on their hometown hero. But the belief is venues are just going to get bigger and bigger and bigger. But before that, and headlining the bill here on Five Spike, on the way is Jason Easton. Last time out was an absolute humdinger. But I tell you what, he gave his corner an absolute heart attack. They'll be looking more disciplined. We'll be looking more fireworks next. It's Jason Easton against Josef Zaradnik. It's the IBO Intercontinental Super Lightweight title on the line next. Our main event now in Five Spike. Last time at Your Call, Jason Easton went to war. This time, his corner probably looking him to be sharper, to be neater, to be a bit tidier. We just want him to continue to have us on the edge of our seats. He brings with him excitement. He does bring with him a touch of the unpredictable. Josef Zaradnik is unbeaten. Jason Easton is unbeaten. And that is the last day on earth anyone will say that line. Your MC is Craig Stephen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the IBO Intercontinental Super Lightweight Crown. Two unbeaten boxers putting it all on the line. Please welcome, firstly, the challenger from Pilsen, Czech Republic, Josef Zaradnik. Well, Josef Zaradnik preparing to go to war here. Nine wins out of nine, and something of an unknown as an opponent. He could be very good, this fella, coming off his career-best win against Filip Nsingi in Dresden, who was unbeaten. Can Zaradnik cause Jason Easton the kind of problems that the better-known Steve Jamoy did last time out? And now, ladies and gentlemen, time to welcome the champion from Edinburgh, Scotland, Jason Easton. He knows that he needs to improve. After that display against Steve Jamoy, when he showed incredible guts to get through, but made a lot of mistakes, they weren't happy with him. Are we going to see the Jason Easton who broke down Rhys Saunders? It was really impressive, surprisingly impressive against Zoltan Szabo, the one who many feel could ride the coattails, dive in the slipstream of Josh Taylor, and maybe when Taylor vacates that Commonwealth title, go on and win that, follow him up, achieve his dreams. But to do all of that, tonight we need a measured, sensible, sharp performance again from Jason Easton, who is hugely popular, and rightly so. Terrific character, rarely in a dull fight. The fight against Jamoy, many felt one of the fights of the year. What will Zaradnik pose in terms of problems? We don't know, but it's the jeopardy that makes Jason Easton exciting. He does look vulnerable, he can be caught, but he also possesses power and great will and self-belief. Ladies and gentlemen, we're in the Royal Highland Centre here in Edinburgh, Scotland. We're live and exclusive on Five Spike. This is our main event on Five Spike this evening, brought to you by Blaine McGuigan's Cyclone Promotions, and proudly sponsored by Maxi Nutrition, by Volterol, and by Ladbrokes. This is 12 rounds of boxing for the IBO Intercontinental Super Lightweight Crown. Contest sanctioned by the International Boxing Organization. Here present, our supervisor, Mr. Andre van Grotenbroel,
And the British Boxing Board of Control, their steward in charge, Mr. Bernard Connolly. And ringside scoring, our three judges. From England, Mr. Michael Alexander. From Germany, Mr. Oliver Bryan. And from the Czech Republic, Mr. Jan Telecki. On the bell, our timekeeper, Jim Kirkwood of Kilmarnock. And when the bell rings, in charge of the action, championship referee from Doncaster, England, Mr. Howard Foster. And now, ladies and gentlemen, time to meet our boxers. Two undefeated boxers. Somebody's all has to go. In the red corner stands the challenger, winning black with gold, weighing in at 9 stone 13 pounds and 2 ounces. He has a perfect record. 9 contests, 9 wins, 4 wins coming by way of KO. He is the reigning Czech super lightweight champion from Pilsen, Czech Republic, Josef Zahradny. And in the blue corner stands the champion, winning black shorts with red trim. He also has a perfect professional record. 10 contests, 10 wins, 6 wins coming inside the distance. He is the reigning Celtic champion. Tonight, he is the reigning and defending IBO Intercontinental Super Lightweight Champion from Edinburgh, Scotland, Jason Easton.
Okay, fellas, both you both in the dressing room. You both know I expect to keep it clean. Break straight away when told. Both you watch your heads in close. Good luck to you both. Touch close. Good luck, lads.
So potentially a tough test this for Jason Easton. This guy, Josef Zahradnik, looks in impeccable shape. Question of how good he is. He won the Czech title in March against Michal Dufek. And Easton needs to start well and needs to keep his discipline. Not get drawn into the kind of wars that he likes. I don't think those in his corner do particularly.
I think Easton, Dave, just takes a little while to warm up, doesn't it? Doesn't he, rather, in terms of his concentration. Occasionally he can just lapse in concentration early on in a contest, a little bit vulnerable. Needs a good warm-up. Let's see how he starts tonight. He can't afford to be sloppy. This fella's undefeated in front of Zahradnik. Looks in good condition, the Czech Republic boxer. So Easton, you know, he'll have to be on the ball early on here.
Zahradnik throwing that right hook, then a left hook, and Easton trying to land a right hand as well. They're both just having a look at each other here. Zahradnik throwing the bigger shots, but not necessarily accurate. That was a good long right hand from Easton. Look for it again there. Got a little nod of respect from Zahradnik.
A good sharp 1-2 combination there from Easton. Just got to be careful that he doesn't throw that jab from too far away. If you watch Zahradnik, he seems to be counter-punching on the back foot. Zahradnik just waiting for Easton to throw that shot. So he can't throw the jab from too far away. He's got to hit the target or follow it through with the 1-2. There you go.
Looks happy to sit on the back foot at the moment, Zahradnik. Easton, though, is the one in the middle of the ring. Zahradnik trying to land a combination.
That's not too bad. There's that right hand you see from Zahradnik. So he's waiting. Oh, that's a good shot from Easton. Lovely shot, right hand. The return fire there. But Zahradnik is just waiting on that back foot for maybe the jab to fall short so he can come back with his own right hand counter. I'm quite impressed with Easton, though, in this round up to now.
Yeah, it's been a little calmer and more controlled so far from Jason Easton.
So he got away with it there, Easton. He just threw that jab, missed the target, fell short, and Zradnik didn't come back with the right hand. But Easton, yeah, he's strong on that front foot, got a good 1-2, hasn't he, as Easton.
Landed a good left hook there, Easton, and then a right to the body. He's definitely got Zaradnik's respect in this first round. It's a little mark above the left eye as well of Zaradnik.
Decent start for Meeson in this round. Misses with the left, but follows through with that right hand. That's a nice 1-2 with the right hand landing. I thought it was a fairly good round for him. Lovely left hand there, and another right hand. And the smiles come from Zaradnik, but he was caught.
Easton out straight away onto the front foot. And Zaradnik is looking to slip those long-limbed Easton shots and try and cause some damage himself. Easton does box well behind those long levers. And he hasn't made too many mistakes so far. He's been accurate and right on cue. He misses with a big right hand.
Always the same. But Easton, if you watch the way he boxes, Dave, he's very good at long range. He's got some lovely long-range punches, the straight left and the right hand in particular, especially as the 1-2. Zaradnik, he's got to shorten the range, he has. He's got to just move in, maybe slip to the left when Easton's throwing that jab and try and whip that right hand over, because at the moment, boxing at distance, he's being outboxed. So he's got to get a little bit closer to Easton, try and catch him with that counter right hand over the top.
Yeah, right now, Easton is certainly happy with the way this is going. Certainly yet to catch fire. We mentioned beforehand that he's rarely in a dull fight. But maybe as he develops and tries to progress, Easton will learn to just be a bit more measured in his work. Huge arena here. Terrific crowd of 3,500 here, largely for Josh Taylor, but roaring on Jason Easton as well. Left jab really there from Easton. Zaradnik responded with a glancing right hand over the top, but another good powerful jab from Easton.
Yeah, I think Zaradnik, he's struggling here, Dave, in terms of the distance. Easton, he's working well at range. He's need long range shots, especially with the jab and the straight right. He seemed to be hitting the target. He's timing him very well indeed. And Zaradnik, I think at range, like I said before, he's struggling a little bit. He can't fathom his opponent out here. So he just threw that shot way off target, but Easton again, strong on the front foot.
Landed a combination again there, Easton. Dominating these rounds at the moment without hurting Zaradnik yet. So impressive the way he dismantled Rhys Saunders and then that early stoppage of Zoltán Csábor. He certainly has power, Easton. 6 knockouts in his 10 wins so far. Again, Zaradnik falling short. Easton is judging the range beautifully now as he really finds his way into this fight.
Easton again, boxing well here, keeping his opponent at range with those long shots. Zaradnik struggling.
Corners, 10 seconds.
The distance, he's been totally outboxed from me.
Seconds out, round 3.
Well, there's a conundrum here for Josip Zaradnik to solve. A classic boxing conundrum. The taller man boxing behind that long arm jab. And Zaradnik needs to somehow get on the inside and somehow make Jason Easton think, because he is happy right now, the Scotsman. Middle of the ring, controlling the fight. Zaradnik is the one who needs to turn the tide here. He's trying at the start of round three.
Got a left hook there from Easton, though.
I think the tempo and the pace is suiting Easton Day, to be quite honest. I think we need a tempo change here from Saradnik. He's got to do something different. He's been outboxed at distance. He's got to get closer and maybe work Easton's body a little bit, but his movement's not good enough on the outside either, so it's fairly routine for Easton. Saradnik got to do more on the inside and probably got to move a little bit more when he's at distance to make that target a little bit more elusive.
Made him miss a couple of times with a jab there, but then Easton lands. Saradnik throwing a right hand, but he was off balance. There was no power behind it. At some point you feel, if it carries on in this vein, Saradnik will run out of ideas. Good idea there from Easton to throw a right to the body. Just try and mix things up. And then a right, though, from Saradnik. Easton was a bit sloppy there.
They both caught each other, I think, simultaneously there, Dave. The right hand went in from Easton, but yet Saradnik threw one himself. But again, you get the feeling, the way it's going, if Easton just keeps on with this long-range work and they're hitting the target, it's those right hands in Saradnik. You know, he's going to get weaker, basically.
Still that reddening over the eye of Saradnik. Noise is absolutely deafening here. Fantastic atmosphere in Edinburgh. Use that uppercut well there, Easton. He's done it a couple of times as Saradnik's overbalanced coming forward. Right hook, though, from Saradnik.
Occasionally you see glimpses of what Saradnik should be doing, or he threatens to work a little bit more on the inside, but he's getting plenty of opportunities, but he's probably not doing enough, Dave, on the inside, Saradnik. He's got to work better in that short-range area, and he's not doing it for me.
Blood from the nose as well of Saradnik, showing who's in charge of this at the end of round three.
Feel a bit more power in these shots.
Yes.
See? Nice and tight, bang that up on hooking. Just do what again, you're standing over the top of him, that's it. Right?
Four words echoing from that corner from Kenny McCartney is discipline, stay disciplined. That was the mantra beforehand, and it continues to be. Jason Easton in those black and red trunks against the Czech champion, Josef Saradnik. Easton's won all three of the opening rounds and continues to look comfortable.
Well, he has got to listen to his corner, though, Dave. His corner saying stay disciplined. Basically, I mean, just stick to your basic boxing, long range work. Don't take too many chances, you're winning the contest. Just break the opponent down by doing what you're doing. If you allow this man on the inside, he's got more of a chance of scoring a shot. So just stick to what you do best. That's boxing at range for me, for Easton.
Well, they told him to look for that uppercut, and he's already done that on a couple of occasions here. So Radnick's a lot more predictable when he comes forward. And Easton has that height and reach advantage as well. He turned pro at 29, Saradnik. Been in and out of the gym, really. Been in it a lot recently, judging from the shape of him, but not enough as Easton landed with a big right hand, tried to follow it up with the right hook, but missed.
I think Easton, Dave, you know, he really feels that he's got the strength over his opponent also, the way he's coming forward. He's very, very confident. He probably thinks that the fella can't hurt him. But a good basic jab again. Saradnik trying to come back with the body shots, but Easton, this is good.
That was the punch of the fight, the right hand then from Easton. That stung Saradnik.
And the weight and the power has gone out of Zaradnik's punches. He was pushing those. They were arm shots. Another right from Easton. He is breaking this fella down. And there's still 50 seconds to go in the round.
Quality right hands now from Easton. You can't keep taking those type of punches. They're going to have an effect on you. Not already Zaradnik now. He's looking a little bit weaker. And this is good for Easton. But it's that long-range right hand that's doing all the damage there.
After that display against Jamoy, he's gone back to the drawing board and regathered, and this has been outstanding. Look at that for a combination. Zaradnik, unsteady on his feet. What a round this is from Jason Easton. Zaradnik will survive the round, but they should get to their feet for Jason Easton there.
It's going to be silly though, right? Yeah. You're looking good, so look good all the time.
Great round from Jason Easton. There's that right hand. That was the best shot of the round. Tremendous stuff. Long range winner. Good 1-2. Very dominant.
Now, has Josip Zaradnik gathered himself together here? Easton landed a left hook right at the start of the round. I'm so impressed with how quickly he's judged the distance here and how accurate he's been as well, Richie, as the fight's gone on. Oh, cut there.
Oh, there's a head clash, I think.
Clash of heads and a cut to the left eye of Easton, and that might just change everything. Is he arguing it was deliberate? Obviously, referee said it was accidental. Look at this from Easton as he puts his foot down.
Yeah, Easton might just go for this now, Dave. He might go for the stoppage, but that's going to leave himself open as well. This is going to be exciting round, Dave.
Suddenly he's in the war, he didn't want to be it. Right there from Easton, Zaradnik still looks unsteady. Easton's got him going, but Easton has blood streaming down his face.
I think, obviously, Zaradnik is a little bit encouraged by that, but at the same time, Dave, he looks the weaker boxer at the moment. Easton is really going for it now. He knows he's got the cut. So he's going for the finish.
Thumping right to the body and then switches to the head. This is warrior stuff from Jason Easton. Backs up Zaradnik and then a right from Zaradnik and Easton. Is this fella ever in a bad fight? Warning from Howard Foster, but punching on the back of the head allows Zaradnik just to gather himself. That cut is nasty.
Thankfully, the blood's just running down the side of the face of Easton.
And then again, the long right. He follows it in with three, four right hands. But again, Zaradnik just hangs on.
Well, he's got to pick his shots here, Dave, now, as Easton's got to work the jab a little bit more and just create that gap and just maintain a gap between himself and his opponent. And he doesn't need Zaradnik on the inside like this because that's giving him a chance. The heads could rub again. That's better. That's what he's got to do more of and maintain a gap between himself and Zaradnik.
Certainly piling up the rounds here, Easton, but he wants to finish it quicker than that. They'll get to work on that cut in the corner. Again, the crowd right behind Easton. And the cut happened so early. He's done well to weather that. They get to work on it straight away. Here's where it happened, Richie.
Yeah, we think it was a head clash, don't we? Let's have a look here. You see, as he comes in, yeah, there was the head. They come together. Easton pulls away. He can feel probably the pain from the cut. He knows that's a bad head clash. Yeah, that's certainly where the cut came from. But Easton, he went for it then, didn't he? He knows that he's got to try and stop his opponent now. And went for him with that right hand. A couple of good shots went in from Easton.
Caught those 10
threw
seconds.
Caution to the wind and really went for it. And again, was his round.
Seconds out, round six.
Well, they've done their best with that cut. Richie has Easton winning all five rounds so far. Accidental clash of heads, of course, if it was brought to a halt because of that cut. We had completed four rounds, so we'd go to the scorecard. Easton would be well ahead.
Easton's just got to watch out for Zaradnik's right hand now over the top. We've got to move a little bit more to his right and away from that right hand, because that could open the cut up again, which it has opened up. We've just got to watch what he's doing here. We've got to keep that left hand of his a little bit higher.
Zaradnik has taken heart from that serious cut to the face of his opponent here. Easton had him going in round four.
You see, that's what he doesn't want to be doing there, Dave. You see, through that sloppy jab then, and Zaradnik came back with his counter. Good response, though, from Easton, but just little signs there that he's got to be sharp with that left hand, and he's got to move to his right more and away from that right-hand counter of Zaradnik's.
See, Howard Foster there had a long look at that cut above his eye. I wouldn't be surprised at all if he brings in the doctor at some point. It does look bad, and it opened up so quickly at the start of this sixth round. Can Easton get the job done, though? Right hook there, and followed with the uppercut, and he catches Zaradnik. Zaradnik again backpedals across the ring. Zaradnik's trying to pretend he's not hurt, but he's hurt all right. Now he comes fighting back.
Just needs a bit of composure now from Easton. And just again measure the distance with the jab before he lets the right hand go. Zaradnik caught with some big shots, but he's game, this Czech Republic boxer. Very game indeed.
Forward comes Easton again. Mustn't use up too much energy here, Easton, but he's going for the finish, and they trade. Feels like we've had about five fights worth of action in the last three rounds here.
Yeah, and again, look, Zaradnik there, just leaning in with his head. Easton has got to try and keep his man at bay. He's going for the stoppage here, Easton. He's putting everything into these shots of his, especially with the right hand.
He's got to be careful in terms of energy conservation here, Easton. Here is a close-up of that work. They're trying to do to stem the flow. It's a bad one, Richie.
Well, it is a bad one, isn't it? Yes, but the blood is running down the side of the face. It's not running into the eye, so the vision's okay. A couple of good shots here from Easton. Then Zaradnik just comes back at him. Terrific work here. Three and four shots went in. Switches the attack from body to head. Zaradnik still a danger, but he walks onto that one and another one. Clowning about, but getting caught. Watch him walk onto this right hand. There he was there. And again, big right hand coming up. That's the one there.
Seconds
good work from Easton.
Round seven.
Now, is he this time going to be a bit cuter and try and move to his right and protect that cut a little bit here, Easton? Remember, early in the fight, he was winning it at range. He knows he can do that. But once he's in a war, he wants to stay in one.
I think he's winning every round, Dave, I really do. He's winning this test comfortably, but it is a good test for him. Zahradnik is still fairly dangerous, throwing lots of shots. But I don't think Zahradnik's really got the power to trouble Easton, and I think Easton knows that.
Josh Taylor is guaranteed brilliance. Jason Easton is guaranteed box office. Long right hand again, followed by the left jab, another right.
Now that's good work.
Trapped in the corner.
Better work from Easton because he's measuring, Dave, with the jab first, left hand, setting up the right. And then he's accurate with that shot, that right hand.
Looking for that uppercut again as Zahradnik just overbalanced on his way in. That was a great left to the body from Easton. Almost felt the air going out of Zahradnik from ringside.
Again, Zahradnik not doing enough on the inside for me, Dave. That's a little bit better, but look, he has plenty of opportunities to work in at close quarters. You think he would be better than what he is on the inside, but sometimes he's just prepared to hold, have a little bit of a breather. But mid and long range, he's been totally outboxed, and there, tracking 1-2 again.
Followed by another powerful right hand. Zahradnik keeps looking like he's going, and then he stays. He is one tough fighter.
Tough lad indeed, Zahradnik.
But I wonder, mentioned it a couple of rounds ago, how much pop there is in those punches from him. He looks tired. Easton punishing to the body again. Great variety again. And a little shuffle as well from Jason Easton. Closing seconds now of round 7.
Tremendous work from Easton with the right hand. Backs Zahradnik up again. Zahradnik, tongue out, fooling around, but getting caught. Staying at mid and long range. Easton totally in control. Just got to compose himself a little bit better with that jab, measure the gap. But he's sending home some cracking right hands. And Zahradnik, give him credit, he is very tough indeed, but he's losing nearly every round for me.
Extend that flow a little bit.
Second time, as much right in that
previous round. Easton back to his boxing. Gum shield out at the start of round 8. Easton looks in control. But Zahradnik is obviously supremely physically fit. Just seems to keep finding energy. Don't know if they're changing his batteries in between rounds, but it's been a remarkable display from him so far.
He recovers well, doesn't he, Zahradnik? Tough lad, he looks a very fit boxer indeed. And you said it, Dave. When you think that he's going to go, he's ready to go, he just comes back and he holds on and he bides a bit of time here and there. And he's a clever kid, tough at the same time. He just lacks a little bit of power. And Easton again landing the better quality shots.
And he overcame a ragged display against Steve Jamoy. Is he going to overcome adversity here bit of tape loose on the glove of all the things.
It's incredible, isn't it, that Easton's had that cut for so long and a lot of blood, and the referee pulls him to the side and they have to do something to the glove. It's boxing.
Still got his eyes fixed on his opponent, though. Still trying to get the job done. Way ahead on the cards, Jason Easton. But he's been looking for the stoppage for the last four or five rounds. Pace has definitely slowed in round eight, no great surprise about that.
And I think that will suit Zahradnik a little bit better than Easton, to be quite honest. Easton, I think he realised it, doesn't he? And he just got on that front foot again. Zahradnik prefers to stay on the outside, which he has done most of the contest. But he's probably benefiting a little bit now from the drop in pace.
Now on the face of Zahradnik as well. It's a bump under the left eye, the one that's got a little bit of blood above it as well, but of course Easton's been protecting that cut on the edge of his left eye. Just thankful for him, as you pointed out, Richie, that it's running down the outside of it. Otherwise, you wonder if it had been able to continue. Listen in to the Eastern corner.
You're letting him recover, Tego. You know what I mean? Can you let him recover? Keep the pace up and catch him. Right? Every time you throw something, you catch him, but you still keep the pace on him. Alright, listen.
Yeah.
Right, let's fucking keep the pace on him then.
Don't let him recover. Yes, more spirited than he did.
Second set, round nine.
So round nine between Jason Easton in those black and red trunks, the local favourite. Starts with a big right hand. Jumped on Zahradnik at the start of this night. He's managed to hurt him early here. Zahradnik still with a smile on his face. More body work from Easton, which strikes you as a good idea. Now he's trying to measure that right hand.
Great right hand, wasn't it? Right at the start of the round. And Easton just kept the attack going. And again, Zahradnik survived. Gets back on the outside. What a great start to the round for Jason Easton. The corner have done a good job, Dave, haven't they, with their eye. They've stopped the flow of blood now.
And Easton has done a good job with it as well. Panicked a bit, didn't he, when it happened. It was a bit wild as Easton jumps onto Zahradnik again. And he's starting to sag now, Zahradnik, when he's caught with these shots.
Yeah, great shot from Easton. It was actually the left hook this time that did the damage there. Zahradnik totally surprised by that shot. Is it just a matter of time now, Dave?
It feels that way. Minute and a half to go in the ninth, and Zahradnik, for the first time, looks really hurt. Easton went for the finish with a big right hook, but missed. Zahradnik again responding with a right of his own, but nothing to trouble Easton. trying to set up his shot behind that left jab. Zarabnik backed in the corner, which is not where the Czech fighter needs to be. Right hand from Easton, and Zarabnik again did well to recover from an awkward situation.
The writing's on the wall, isn't it? Easton just picking his shots now. Very, very confident.
Short left there, and then a right to the chin. Howard Foster is poised on his toes. Another big right, then a left uppercut. 30 seconds to go in the round. Howard Foster had a good look that time. He's as aware as we are of how durable Zarabnik is, though, and he's giving him a chance. He's still fighting back, and he's still protecting himself. And he survived, it would seem, another round here, Josip Zarabnik.
Tremendous work from Easton in this round. This was the start of it, wasn't it? This was the opening 20 seconds or so. Short, sharp right hand. And Zarabnik is in trouble. Different angle, same punch. Cracking shot there from Easton as the round went on. There's that big left hook. He wasn't expecting it. I think he was thinking a jab was coming. He just changed the angle, threw the hook. Right at the end of the round, Easton pours on the pressure. This is very clever from Zarabnik, actually, because he just missed.
Seconds.
Just avoids the right hand that's to follow in that sequence. But another dominant
seconds
round.
Out, round 10.
He's only in his 11th fight, Jason Easton. Much more to come from him, but feels like he's learnt a lot this year. He's learnt a lot tonight. Still that cut is spilling blood. Good from Easton, just to look to the body as well as the bigger, flashy, more obvious shots to the head.
I think Zarabnik, you can see that blood flowing again.
Oh, and from Easton, and Zarabnik was so unsteady on his legs, and he's caught again there. Two uppercuts followed in from Easton. Still looks unsteady to me, Zarabnik, but then again, not for the first time tonight. And he somehow seems to recover.
Just before he got caught with that right hand, Dave, I think he was seeing the blood that was flowing down the side of Easton's face, and he was encouraging him to throw that right hand again. He started the round with a couple of good right hands over the top, but he comes undone. Big shots from Easton. His right hand especially has been the punch tonight, hasn't it, at range.
Zarabnik just avoided that right hook. That looks worse, you know.
Yeah, it has got worse.
Steady stream of blood now down the left-hand side of Easton's face. Again, it will encourage Zarabnik.
And that's why Easton has just got to increase that gap again, keep his man at bay. The cut is getting worse. See, that's better. That's good boxing, that is. Measuring the gap and then bringing them shots through.
Then he sent Zarabnik back on his heels. Closing moments of the round, and Zarabnik tumbled into Howard Foster there. Again, he's targeting that left eye, Zarabnik. Easton needs a strong finish to the round here. Both slowing down, both tiring. Not surprising given how tough this fight has been.
So just Easton there, just trying to protect that eye, but Zahradnik just coming across with that right hand. This is the start of the round, so the blood starts coming down the face, and it just encouraged him a little bit, but then he gets caught with a cracking right hand at long range again. That's been his best punch tonight, Easton, that long-range right hand. Easton again, that's lovely, measuring the gap with that 1-2. Zahradnik just comes back with a couple of his own shots. So he's still competitive, Zahradnik. Got to give him a lot of credit.
Seconds out, round 11.
Not there yet, but he's not far away, Jason Easton. If it is going to go to points, he will win by a wide margin. And look at that, another massive shot to start a round. How many times does Easton need to do that before this fella finally succumbs?
Better boxing.
Combination, much better boxing, isn't it?
Yeah, because he's keeping the gap, you see now. So he's learning, his Easton, the way he boxed there. He didn't just fall in on his opponent. He's punching, but maintaining a gap to create those opportunities and openings again. Earlier on in this contest, Davey, he'd have fell in there, trying to probably get rid of his opponents, get him out of there, but that was clever. Just boxing at range, mid-range work. And Zahradnik again comes back with a couple of good right hands there.
It's all about that footwork, isn't it, Richie, that's not instantly evident, you know, the little half steps here and there create that space.
And you learn that throughout the contest. He's learned that throughout this contest. They're just maintaining that gap so he can just get the shots off, rather than smothering his work. When you're up too close, sometimes you smother your own work, or your opponent holds you and you can't punch. You've got to take that half a step back, create that space to let the shots go.
Zahradnik, of course, targeting that eye of Easton. Blood now streaming from his nose as well. These two have given it absolutely everything. It feels, though, always as if Easton's got that little bit in hand. He lands another big right hand.
Scrappy around. Well, this period of anyway, because they're up close, aren't they? Zahradnik having a little bit of success here and there.
You haven't come close so far to giving him a round, have you?
No, I haven't. He's been competitive throughout most of the rounds, but the eye-catching work, the better boxing for me, has come from Easton in almost every round. Well, every round up to now.
Tired-looking punches there from Easton. And from Zahradnik. Surely the message for Easton now has to be, you've got the fight won, just be sensible from now on in. But I'm not sure at times that he does sensible. And that makes him watchable. Filling ahead of Josh Taylor, Miguel Vasquez. Jason Easton, chief support, and of course our headline show here on Five Spike. Oh, what a fight they've given us, these two.
Good start to the round from Easton. Started this really well. Good left there, kept the attack going, works the body with that right. Three or four shots upstairs. Too bad at all to start this round. That's a bad one.
Almost 10 seconds. Seconds of
it,
12th and
it
last
one. Dramatic though, Richie, but the punishment on the face of Zaradnik is clear to see as well. Nice touch of gloves. They've got great respect for each other now, these two, at the start of the 12th and final round. Easton still trying to hurt him, still trying to finish it. Combination from Easton and Zaradnik, still landing his punches as well. More power though in Easton's work.
Eye-catching work is from Easton, isn't it? But you've got to give Zaradnik a lot of credit, you know. He's one tough cookie, and he's not a bad boxer himself, just lacks a little bit of power. And for me, could have done more on the inside, but he's been competitive right throughout.
Just feel though that the way he's approached it was not the way he was ever going to win the fight, Zaradnik. Maybe a way to survive, but not to challenge for the win. Had to be a closer range, bit uglier maybe.
Yeah, I don't think he expected to be hit as much as he has, but at long range. I think he probably thought he could avoid the shots and try and counter better with his right hand. There's a nice shot from him. But it just didn't happen, and he was too slow off the mark. He was too slow with those counters. He wasn't moving enough on the outside, and Easton, for me, has just got better and better.
Long left hook there that he threw from the back of the hall, Easton. He's not trying to cruise to the win, is he? Which he could do. He's trying to win every second of every round and stop this fella.
I mean, the fitness of both these boxers has been tremendous. I honestly didn't think Zaradnik would have lasted this long because he got caught with too many big right hands, but he's in tremendous shape, Zaradnik. And Easton has really put a shift in himself here.
Well, I hope this crowd, I'm sure they will, get to their feet for both of these men. Easton, of course, has all of the support, but Zaradnik deserves plenty of respect too. Final 25 seconds. Zaradnik needs a miracle. Easton, though, is still trying to force the stoppage. Not gonna. I think a lot of people will be pleased to see Zaradnik hear the final bell. Game display. A clear win for Easton that needs to be confirmed on the scorecards. And a big test as well for Easton, because things go against you in boxing, and he managed to overcome one there.
Yeah, he would have learned a lot from that contest. He kept going. He didn't panic, did he? He went for it, though, at one stage when he got the cut. But at the end of the day, he kept his boxing together. Mentally, he stayed strong. He's very fit indeed. It's been a tremendous workout for him. And Zaradnik really played his part. Probably just lacks a little bit of power and couldn't trouble Easton. But nevertheless, I thought it was an exciting contest right to the last bell.
Well, Easton now goes over to Zaradnik's corner. And that's nice to see, isn't it? There was a real look of respect on Easton's face. As if to say, you are one tough fighter. And there you go, Easton raises his hand as well. It will be Easton's hand being raised at the end, but a good bit of matchmaking as well. Good opponent, Zaradnik.
Well, there won't be many opponents that will take that type of punishment from Easton and still be standing at the end of 12 rounds, so... Yeah, full respect to Zaradnik, and that's why Jason Easton lifted the fella's hand, because it was a brave display, but he's just not quite strong enough for Easton, and Easton, for me, yeah, he's learned a little bit more tonight, and he's taken one step further on in his career. Yeah, good learning fight for him.
The other thing as well, we were looking for more discipline, and we were getting that. And in a way, that plan went out of the window once he was cut. He did what he felt he had to do. But was it better, Jason Easton, tonight?
Absolutely, yeah. Like I said, Dave, I mean, that was, what, his 11th contest, and he's learnt a little bit more. Yeah, good test for him.
Well, time just to confirm what will surely be a comfortable points win for Jason Easton. But here's Craig.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we go to our judging score totals, a referee, Howard Foster, has asked that you join him. 12 rounds of championship boxing. Please, your appreciation for both boxers in the ring. So we go to our judges' score totals. Judge Jan Terlecki, 117, 111. Michael Alexander, 118, 110. Oliver Bryan, 120, 108. All in favour of the winner. And still, the IBO Intercontinental Champion, Jason Easton.
Dave Farr said Jason Easton is guaranteed box office, 100%, that sums this fighter up. But I tell you what isn't box office, tonight's whole event, no 20 quid required, free to air and 5 Spike, and Josh Taylor on Channel 5, not far away, but stay right here, we'll build up to that, and we'll look back on that bludgeoning win for Easton next.
Points by paying for your holiday with the Preferred Rewards Gold Card.
Well, it has to be said, Jason Easton made a class. Josef Zahradnik maybe made of granite. So much to talk through, but first of all, how did you feel in there in that early round? More calm, more composed?
Yeah, I felt really relaxed in the fight. I felt like in tight and at range, I was beating him every aspect in the game there. I was beating him. I felt like he couldn't hurt me when I was inside and I was tight guard. A weak head class, and I think the third or the fourth was it. And it sort of, like you said, it tricked the switch for a second, and I wanted to get him out there, but I thought Joe McCluskey did an excellent job in the corner and went back to corner with a cut. And I thought I'll just relax and just enjoy it and just beat him, outbox him. If the stoppage came, then I would go for it, but I felt relaxed and just get the win.
Well, the adrenaline's pumping with you, and you've done the A to Z of that fight in about 15, 20 seconds. I want to enjoy it a lot more. So straight away, you realise quite early that, listen, this guy can't hurt me, and that relaxes you. At what point did you realise he can take a punch at a class level?
I think it's when I hit my about a 20-punch combination, and he just looked at me and smiled. So kind of like Steve Dumoy when he crunched his neck and just looked at me and laughed. But you know what? Fair play, Joe Zahradnik, tough boy, he's unbeaten for a reason, and he came and gave it a go, so respect to him.
Well, listen, Alex is here, he lived every round with you. Let's go through it round by round, Alex, and we can see just what a thriller it was.
Jason started really well on the long range shots, brilliant jab, excellent 1-2s. I was hoping to see him double up the jab and go in behind his right hand. Jason, for a really tall guy at 5'11", is actually brilliant up close. He'll touch the head with a couple of shots, he'll roll under a counter, and he'll drop a body shot in brilliantly. So I was hoping that Jason would close down the distance with his long straights and then finish up on the body. But again, this guy was unbelievably tough, had a granite chin, dipped the head very well, and took a great shot flush. So on a few occasions, I thought Jason had him going. After the fourth round, I motioned to the corner that he possibly wouldn't go another four rounds, but I held on, and fair play to him.
Everything I was doing there, the straight 1-2s, keeping the back leg straight, I seem to jump in forward a lot before. And there I was keeping the back leg planted when I was tripping, I was jumping forward, not swinging it round. Exactly what I've been mucking with Kenny. I owe everything to Kenny. The amount of time and effort Kenny puts into me is ridiculous.
Jason, did you feel at any point that you were going to stop him? Or did you know that it was going to go the distance?
There was a couple of times I thought I was going to stop him. I think that's where I stepped on him with 20 punches. I remember you saying in my last fight in the commentary, if he just threw maybe 10, 20 punches in a flurry, I would stop him, so that's what I tried to do. But he just kept smiling at me, so respect to Joseph for that.
You sure did keep him coming, though, in a really impressive manner. It was excellent.
Yeah, and you just, during that VT, you leant over out of shot and you give this man a kiss in the head. This is such an enduring relationship that's been going well over a decade now. From a coaching point of view, how impressed are you by how he conducted himself in that ring tonight?
A lot better this time than he was the last time. I was more interested in his feet work, his defence. What happened last time, as we all saw, he took away a load of shots.
Yeah.
And it was just, we weren't wanting that. Eh? And to be honest, after four or five rounds, we thought he was going to finish this guy. Yeah. But once the cut came, it was as well just relaxing, get back to boxing, see what happened. And I don't know how the guy's still standing.
He's just so much credit.
I mean, really tough.
As you know, Zaradnik, I wouldn't like to see the nick of him in the morning with the amount of shots that he took, to be fair. Listen, how is your... What is it like when a boxer tastes blood? Because I saw it in your eyes, you know, 2 yards away, when you tasted blood. That's when the Street Fighter came out for a couple of rounds.
I think it's where I've grown up in Nibri. I like Alex grown up most of his life as well. I think it's that Nibri blood in me. That fighting me, I'm just tough. I'm a tough guy.
Yeah.
I'll fight for the 12 rounds like that. So bring it on.
Well, let's have a look at just how you picked that cut up, because he was never going to harm you with a punch, and straight away you felt it, you knew it was opened up. So the instinct kicks in, you worry about getting him out of there. It should be said, under the rules of this particular organisation, it would have went to the points anyway, which must calm you down.
Yeah, that's it. I knew that. I knew if it did go to points, I was winning anyway, so I was in complete control of the fight. Never felt in danger one time through the fight, so I knew if it did go to points, it was going to win anyways. But there was times I thought, I'm not going to take that risk, because anything can happen on the scorecard, so I thought I'd try and get him out, but there you go, I got the win, that's all that matters, and I'm still champ. So.
Listen, it can be boxers that can go in there, they can be prolifically technical, world-class in that level, and bore everyone to sleep. This guy's got the entertainment and the ability matched in, so I suppose you would say to the people that look after you, and the people look after those fighters slightly ahead of you on that ladder to glory, bring it on, fight me, I'll put people in seats anywhere in this country.
Yeah. Fine. What's that a question? Sorry, is that a question? Yeah. I didn't know if that was a question. I just thought you were freezing him up there. Sorry. But yeah, thanks, man. Thanks.
And in terms of Josh tonight, you're good mates. Like, you know, I know you've been talking to him right through. Just give us a bit of an inside track of where his mind is tonight.
Well, I did a lot of sparring, and I grew up through the amateur ranks with Josh Taylor. He's an excellent fighter. And I think you're going to see a massive improvement again tonight. I just think he's an excellent fighter and he's going to demoralise Vasquez. I think it's going to be a tough fight. I just think he's going to be a bit too much for him.
Listen, Jason Kenny, fantastic. Off you go. You might have a date with a needle and thread back there, but it'll be all worth it. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
Well done, lads. Different
class. Lovely guy. Brilliant. Well, there you go. Big victory there, and a fight that went longer than a round or two, which has been unusual for tonight. But right at the beginning of this evening, we welcome to the ring, as the seats were starting to fill up, a wonderful, one of the futures of female boxing.